Hey guys, it's Gobo VR, and this time I show you how to create another Insta360 shot lob effect with any 360 camera. Actually, it's not only a standalone trick, but a short sequence of at least 5 or 6 clips you can use almost in any videos or travel vlogs. The main difference between using the mobile app or edit everything manually on desktop is that we have more freedom during shooting and editing. We can play around with different angles, and we have full control over the camera movements during post-production. And of course, we can export our videos even in 4K. Besides talking about the basics, let me share a couple of extra tricks with you. To shoot time flip effect, I mount the camera on the invisible selfie stick and extend it to full length. Depending on the scene, I can shoot with normal and double speed too. This time I choose the highest resolution possible and real-time shooting. Standing with my back against a flat surface or wall, I swing the camera in one direction, or I repeat the movement a couple of times back and forth. I start and end the swing close to the wall, so I prefer to turn away the lenses, so none of them will face the wall. This way I can prevent the glass elements from accidentally crashing into the surface and break. Looking at the camera on the end of the stick, I follow the arc with my head, trying to turn with the same speed to make it look natural. Then all I need to do is find at least 5 or 6 further locations to repeat the process. On the other hand, you can play around with different unusual locations, camera heights and positions. Among others, what about lying instead of standing by the wall? Due to the blind area on the bottom of the camera, the invisible selfie stick will be really invisible. But sometimes the hand position can be a little bit weird. Wearing black gloves can solve this problem, and your hand won't attract so much attention. Or you can use further objects around you, like railings or anything like that, so your hands and the way you move the camera will be even less noticeable. And after recording a few takes, we can go on with post-production. But talking about editing, maybe you've already noticed something new in the background. Yes, I have a small accessory on my monitor, which I really like to use during editing. You know, staring at electronic screens all day can cause eye problems and impairs vision in the long run. So I started to use this screen bar, making post-production a little bit more comfortable for myself. If you're interested about this additional monitor light, check out my review in the right top corner. But now let's jump into Premiere Pro and continue editing this cool time flip effect. After importing my RAW videos, I pick up the first take and create a new sequence from it. Then I just select the in and out points, wall to wall, focusing only on the best flip. It's very important that the motion should start from one side and end on the other, and I just crop the clip. In my previous videos, you could have seen my favorite reframing technique, working with adjustment layers. But this time I won't put multiple 360 videos up on each other, so I apply the reframing plugin on each and every clip separately. This time I use the latest GoProFX reframe plugin. I drag and drop it on top of my footage. I set up the output to 4K. Of course, I could play around with other target formats, even with creating square or vertical videos for Instagram or Instagram Story. But as you can see, no matter which format I choose, my reframed videos don't fit to the 5.7K canvas anymore. There will be an empty black frame around them. But don't worry, we'll easily solve this problem later. And now I just keep on working with a normal horizontal 4K output for a while. I just go to the effect properties and start to play around with the virtual camera pan. I have the safe margins guide turned on, so I can align myself exactly in the middle of the frame. I wanna keep myself in the center, so as I swing the camera, I change the values of the pan parameter, creating keyframes. And I also fine-tune the settings on the Y-axis too, down on the advanced settings. And of course I can add some further keyframes to the rotation and zoom too. The point is that I try to keep myself in the middle of the frame in the same size during the swing. And when I'm done with one location, I continue with another one. Then finally I put all the very similar clips on the same timeline. Now all I have to do is creating some nice and seamless cuts. At this point, feeling the rhythm of the video is essential. That's how I can find the final cutting point at each clip. In most of the cases, it's the matter of taste, but I like to keep up with the momentum. I cut the clips before they start slowing down. Or of course, sometimes it's cool to play around with time remapping to make some clips even better. And when I'm done, it's time to get rid of the black bars or black frames around my clips. It doesn't matter which aspect ratio you prefer, it's the same simple method. I select all the final clips and mask them. And then I duplicate the whole 5.7K sequence, open and resize it to the target frame size. In this case, I make a 4K video. I press OK and my black frame is gone. If I zoom out a little bit, you can see the black frame is still there, but I just simply crop the useless parts of the original frame, and I have a perfect 4K video. Of course, this method works perfectly with any other aspect ratio, depending on your needs. For instance, on my Instagram, you can find a vertical version of the same scene clicking on my stories. But basically that's all, and that's how you can shoot and edit time flip videos and reframe your contents with GoPro FX plugin. I hope you like these tips and tricks and find them useful. If you do, please thumbs up, and for further 360 contents and tutorials, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and browse my playlists. See you next time!